In this video, I'll show you how to go from this single feather into a fully grown animated wing in 6 steps.
Let's get started.
Delete everything and leave the default cube. Select your default cube, go to edit mode and start extruding to the right to create our wing arm. It should be easy enough. You can press S on your keyboard to scale and E on your keyboard to extrude outwards. Now we are going to fix some of the issues right here. Let's put a subdivision modifier on it. It looks a bit wonky right now, but select your mesh, go to edit mode and place a loop in the middle and 2 for each of the extrusion we made. There you go. Shade it smooth, and now we are going to use proportional editing to shape the wing to our liking. Now we are going to hide the wing arm and create a new collection and call it feather. Now if you haven't already turned on the import images as planes add-on, turn it on and then shift A on your keyboard, import images as planes, and now select your feathers, import them as planes. Select your feather, go to edit mode and put 2 loop cuts in the middle, 1 horizontal and 1 vertical. Now select each of the edges and press G on your keyboard to bring them up a little bit, because feathers are not flat and they are 3-dimensional. Same thing for the other feather.
In the end, we will place these feathers onto our armature. If you don't want to place both of them manually to see which one's gonna fit better, you can just place one of them, and I will show you a little tip in the end. And with that, you would be able to change the material for a specific feather or a bunch of them if you want. So make sure to watch this video to the end. While I'm doing this, why don't you go and help me out a bit by liking this video.
And now we are going to bring the wing arm back and focus on that. Let's create the bones for it. Shift A on your keyboard, armature and single bone. Place it right in the middle of the chicken arm. Just like this. Select your bone, go to the object data properties, and under viewport display, change it to envelope and check in front. In my opinion, it's better for the eye and easier to control. It should look like this. And now we are going to start placing the feather bones. Place them very carefully, because this will determine your wing shape in the end. Shift D to copy this bone, Alt S to scale it down a bit, and now I will start placing the feather bones. Select the end and we can extrude, Alt S to scale it down. Okay, so select the first bone, go to the bone properties, and under relation, change it to the first bone, the one is statically above, so it will follow the movement of this bone. Now copy and paste and do it for all of the other bones. So for this bone, we are going to change the relation to the second bone, because we wanted to follow the bone above it, the second bone, not the first one. We are going to place every single bone manually. And now we are going to add some constraints to our bone. Select the first bone, go to bone constraint properties, and add a copy rotation constraint. Select target as the armature and the bone as the second bone. Select the target and honor to local space, and now it will follow the second bone. Turn up the influence a bit so it's not as strong. Now if you haven't already turned on the copy attributes add-on, turn it on. Now select every bone, and in the end you have to select the bone you want to copy from. So Control C on your keyboard, copy bone constraints, and now all of them are going to follow the bone we want to, but they are moving a bit too uniformly, so we have to tweak a bit of the settings to make it a bit random and maybe remove the constraint from some of the bones. Now it's time to parent the wing arm to the armature. Select your arm, shift select your armature, Control P on your keyboard, and parent it with automatic weights. Now go to pose mode and check if there's any problems. If there are any problems like this, you can select your armature, shift select your arm, and go to weight bearing mode, and then shift select your bone, and it will show you which area it's controlling. So I'm shift selecting different bones and seeing what it's controlling, and I will paint or remove accordingly. Now I will manually place all the feathers onto the bones. And now I'm going to hide all of the feathers, focus on a single one, select the feather, Shift select your armature and Control P on your keyboard and pair it with automatic weights. I'm going to turn on the names for it so I can see which bone I am parenting it to. Now select your armature, shift select the feather and go to weight pin mode. Control shift to select the bone, and now I will add weight to the bone which I want it to follow. So Control shift select your bone and draw on it. There you go. Control shift on the first bone and I'm rotating it to see if there's an issue. Looks like there are. Remember to select the bones which are the closest and see if there's any weight there. If there is, remove it. Everything's working fine, and now focus on the second feather. Select your feather, shift select the armature and Control P with automatic bends. Shift select your bone and fix the weight just like we did before. Remove it from the bones we don't want and add it to the bone we want. This is going to be a bit tedious, but it is what it is. Let's focus on the end part. Stop staring at the screen and keep wondering like how I'm gonna do it. Brute force it just like I did. Now when you're done with all of the feathers like this, for the long feathers, select every one of them and Control J on your keyboard to join them together to make it into a single object. It will not affect your weight painting, so don't worry. And now we are going to create a set of small feathers on each side. The same process goes for this. Weight paint, parent, weight paint, parent, and Control J on your keyboard to join them at the end. So in the end, we will have like one set of long feathers and two set of short feathers on each of the side, and in the middle we will have the long feathers. And now I will show you how the rig is going to work. In the meantime, please leave a like, comment, and subscribe for more videos like this.
If you want to skip all of this work and get these wings for yourself, you can go to my Patreon page and you can get these wings. Keep in mind that I will also upload future project files from my YouTube and also some exclusive assets that I create on my Patreon. If you do become a member on my Patreon, it will help me create more content and tutorials for you guys more frequently. For the material, go into your principal BSDF and turn up the transmission. I'm also going to add a RGB curves to make it a bit darker. I'm in edit mode, so I'm going to select some of the feathers, hover over them and press L on your keyboard, just like this. Create a new material and assign it to them. And here we are going to select the second feather we imported. Do the same for the second material, turn up the transmission a bit so there is going to be light passing through it and it will make it look a bit realistic.
And now I am going to create a custom object for our three main bones. So shift A on your keyboard, empty. It can be anything. I just like this empty. So select your armature, go to edit mode or pose mode, go to the bone properties and under viewport display, change this to this object you just created. And now you can move it around or scale it up or down just the way you like. I am going to repeat this process for all these three main bones, so it will be easier to animate in the end. Now let's create these hair particles. Add a hair particle system to your wing arm, turn the hair length down, go to the hair shape and make it a lot thinner. Under children, interpolate it, 54 should be fine. And under roughness, turn up the random and threshold a bit. They are still a little bit thick, so I'm going to make them thinner. As you can see, I created a collection called small feathers. I edited the feather to make it a bit thicker and a bit smaller. Now make another particle system, and this time under render settings, change it to object and select the feather. Now select everything, shift D on your keyboard to duplicate them and right click and mirror on the X axis. Shift A on your keyboard to create a new empty. I created a circle. Select both of your wings, the armature, and shift select the empty you created and parent it to it. And now we can control the wings with the empty object we created. We can also move them separately or move them together with the empty object. To go to pose mode with both of the wings, shift select both of your armatures and go to pose mode. Just like that. And now we can animate and do all the fun stuff after that. And in the next video, I will show you how to create VFX with the strings you just created. So stay tuned for that. And in the meantime, if you want to learn how to create an animated growing plant or 3D hair in Blender, watch these videos. Thank you so much for watching. Make sure to smash that like button and subscribe for more videos like this.